Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get notified.
Mind scattering. See, mind scattering is actually responsible for the white appearance of the clouds. It is caused by smoke water droplet. What is smoke? What is water droplet? I'll tell you why clouds are in white color. See, water droplets are present inside the clouds. Not only water droplets, some other particles are also there inside the clouds. You consider this as sun and clouds. When the white light falls on the water droplet which is present inside the clouds, all the colors are, usually white light has all the seven colors, right? So when white light falls on the water droplets, all the colors are equally scattered, which together to form the white color. That is why the clouds are in white color. I hope now you understood why the clouds are in white color. Okay, now we are going to see what is Tyndall scattering. You understand one thing, Tyndall scattering is also known as Tyndall effect. Very easy to understand, okay. When a beam of light enters into the dusty room through window, its path is visible. How it is visible? Because of the tiny particles that is present in the air that scatters the beam of light. Okay, this effect is said to be Tyndall effect or Tyndall scattering. The definition for Tyndall scattering is the scattering of the light rays by the colloidal particle in the colloidal solution is called Tyndall effect or Tyndall scattering. I will tell you one more example. See, I have drawn a beaker here. It is filled with a colloidal solution. What is colloidal solution? You can take a solution which the water mixed with milk is also said to be the colloidal solution. Okay. You make the light rays to pass through the beaker. The colloidal particle that is present inside the beaker scatters the light. This scattering is said to be Tyndall scattering. What is said to be colloidal particle? A colloidal particle is a small particle with a dimension scale ranging from nanometer to micrometer. I hope you all understood what is Tyndall scattering. Now we are going to discuss what is Raman scattering. Okay, now we are going to see what is Raman scattering. Before we see this topic, you should know what is monochromatic. Mono, what do you mean by the term mono? Mono is nothing but single, right? And chromatic, it is related to color. So, single color is said to be monochromatic. See, when a parallel beam of monochromatic light passes through either pure liquids or transparent solid, a part of light ray will get scattered. We know when a light ray passes from one medium to another medium, the light ray will get scattered, right? The scattering rays have additional frequencies or wavelength other than the incident frequency or wavelength. Then such a scattering is said to be Raman scattering. We know, you consider, see, this as a transparent solid. Okay, it is transparent solid. You making the monochromatic light to pass through. When the light is passing from one medium to another medium, the light rays get scattered. See, when the light ray is incident here, it may have one frequency and wavelength. After scattering, there will be a changes in the frequency and wavelength. If there is a changes, then it is said to be Raman scattering.